Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. First of all, a very happy new year to all of you. Today, in this video, I am going to show you how to run Python program on our Visual Studio Code. So do watch the video till the end. In this video, I am going to talk about how to install Visual Studio Code, then how to install Python, and then I am going to give you a demo code on Python and how to run that within our Visual Studio Code. And also, I am going to talk about the plugins that you will need, or extensions you can say. So what are all extensions that we'll need within Visual Studio Code so that you can, you know, write your Python program within our Visual Studio Code. So do watch the video till the end. I can promise you that you'll be learning a lot of new things. And I have also started this Geeky Syntax channel. So here I'm going to post coding and programming related videos. So you know, you need to subscribe this channel. If I get, you know, significant amount of subscriber, I'm going to regularly post more videos on Geeky Syntax. And also I have started a Geeky Script blogging channel. So if you're interested, you can always subscribe this channel as well. So for Python to run on within Visual Studio Code, first thing that you'll need is to download Python itself. You need to just simply type Python download, and it's going to show you this download Python over here. So you need to open that, and you can see that our latest version of Python is currently Python version 3.12.1. You need to just simply click on this download button, and you can see that our latest version of Python is rightly started downloading. So to, you know, just simply click on the exe in order to install it locally on your system. And here you need to just simply click on install anyway. And you can see that install Python 3.12.1 for all users. So here you need to just simply, you know, check this add python.exe to path, and then you need to click on custom installation. And here you need to select this for all users and click on next. So here also you need to select this install Python 3.12 for all users, and then it is just simply click on install. And when you click on install, it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and there you go. You can see our installation of Python is rightly began. So you know, let's wait for some time to get it finished installing our Python. By the time it get installed, I'll just simply open a new tab, and I'll just type over here Visual Studio Code download. And it will show you this download Visual Studio Code. So you need to open that official site of Visual Studio Code. So both this link, Visual Studio Code and Python, I'm going to put right in our description. All right, and here we need to click on this download button for Windows. So when you click on that, it's going to start downloading our Visual Studio Code. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel it. You can see that same file is already been downloaded over here. So I'll just simply click on the Visual Studio Code to install it. So let's minimize our browser. So you need to accept this license agreement and click on next. And here also you need to click on next. Again next. You need to check all these check boxes. Click on next and install. And you can see that it is preparing to install. So our Visual Studio is, you know, getting installed along with our Python as well. So let both the things get finished installing on our system, and I'll be then back to this video again. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our Python is successfully installed. Also our Visual Studio Code is successfully installed. So our desktop shortcut for Visual Studio Code is also created. So first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to just simply click on close for our Python, and you can see Visual Studio is installed. So launch Visual Studio Code is also enabled. So just simply click on finish. So that will launch our Visual Studio Code. All right. So in my previous video, I talked about how to run HTML on Visual Studio Code. So that's why you can see that project is opened over here. I'll just simply close this now. All right. Now, before I write anything on our Visual Studio Code, the first thing that I'll recommend you to do is just simply go to search and just type over here CMD. So that will show you this command prompt. Open the command prompt, and here you need to just simply type Python space dash dash version and simply hit enter, and you will see the latest version of Python is showing, right? Python 3.12.1. So I want you to verify this once before you proceed with this video. If you see something like Python is not recognized as an internal or an external command, then all that basically means is you have some issues with installing Python. So you need to follow this video all over again. You can always put a comment if you see any issues happening. All right. So that is the one thing that I wanted to clarify. You need to have Python installed. So you can see that is coming. So once you see that, fine, you can close this now. So next thing that you need to do is you need to go to this Explorer and you need to click on this folder icon. So for that we can create a folder like, let's say, python_practice. Alright, so you are creating a folder called Python practice folder, and within our Python practice folder we are going to create a file. So click on plus of the file icon and just simply give the file name as prog.py. Alright, so py is very essential. Py basically means, you know, a Python file that you want to create. So click on outside, you can see that prog.py file is rightly, you know, created and it is opened over here. Parallelly, if you see, it is also giving you a recommendation that it is, you know, telling that install the recommended Python extension from Microsoft for Python language. So when you click on the show recommendation, it will, you know, automatically going to navigate to the extension of Python, so developed by Microsoft itself. So one way is to click on the show recommendation to come over here, or else you can just simply click on these extensions and can just simply type Python here, and that will also going to show you the same Python over here, right? So you can just simply click on install to install our Python. So we'll need Python. Another thing that I'm going to recommend you to install is Code Runner. So just simply type Code Runner and you will be able to see this extension, Code Runner dot run, Code Runner, right? So here you can see that it supports C, C++, Java, JS, basically JavaScript, PHP, Python, Perl, all these languages, right? So what it will do is it will give you a nice, you know, sweet run button over here. So once you install that, you're going to get that run button. So only clicking of that button itself, you'll be able to run any sort of code like C or C++, whatever language you write. So it's going to support that. You can see that sweet run button is now present, right? So that is coming from this Code Runner. And here you can see that our Python is also installed, Python extension. So everything is, you know, good. Let's close all this and go back to our folder where we have created this prog.py. So here let's give, you know, write a simple program. Like, it's going to be a very simple program. Okay, I'm just simply going to print hello world. Nothing much. So hello world, and you can just simply go to file and save this file. So if you, you know, click on this expand and click on this run Python file, what it's going to do is it's going to, you know, start, you know, showing you the output hello world on our terminal. So that's basically all about this video. We can, you know, start writing your Python projects, whatever you probably have given from your college or your school, all assignments you can, you know, start completing within our Visual Studio Code itself. In my next videos, I'm going to talk about how to debug Python program. So that's going to be a very important video. So what I'm going to do on that video is I'm going to show you probably a big program of Python. So generally what happens is in real life, like, you probably have a project which contains thousands of lines of code, all right, and it is really very difficult to debug line by line, like all those code, right? Is very difficult. So it is important to debug, right, one by one sequentially you can debug. So how to debug a Python program? So that is what I'm going to discuss in my next video. So, you know, do subscribe this channel, press that bell button, and if you have any issues you can always comment in our comment sections, and don't forget to share with your friends. That really helped me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.